No one would have believed that in the last years of the 19th century, human affairs were being watched from the timeless worlds of space. No one could have dreamed that we were being scrutinized as someone with a microscope that studies creatures that swarm and multiply in a drop of water. Few men even considered the possibility of life on other planets. And yet, across the gulf of space, minds immeasurably superior to ours regarded this Earth with envious eyes. And slowly, but surely, they drew their plans against us.
Mass of luminous gas erupted from Mars and sped towards Earth. Across 200 million miles of void, invisibly hurtling towards us,
came the first of the missiles that would bring so much calamity to Earth. As I watched, there was another jet of gas, was another missile starting on its way. Next 10 nights, a flare spurting out from Mars, bright green, drawing the green mist behind it. Beautiful and somehow disturbing sight. Ogilvy, the astronomer, assured me we were in no danger. He was convinced there could be no living thing on that remote, forbidding planet.
The chances of anything coming from Mars are a million to one, he said. Of anything coming from Mars, a million to one, but still they come.
Then came the night the first missile approached Earth. It was thought to be an ordinary falling star, but the next day there was a huge crater in the middle of the comet, and Ogilvy and I came there to examine what lay there. A cylinder, 30 yards across, glowing hot, with faint sound of movement coming from within it. Suddenly the top began rotating, unscrewing, and Ogilvy feared there was a man inside trying to escape. He rushed into the cylinder, but the intense heat stopped him before he could burn himself off the metal.
The chances of anything coming from Mars are a million to one, he said. The chances of anything coming from Mars are a million to one. But still, they come. The chances of anything coming from Mars are a million to one, he said. The chances of anything coming from Mars are a million to one. But still, they come.
Totally incredible to me now that everyone spent that evening as though it were just like any other. From the railway station came the sound of shunting trains, ringing, rumbling, softened almost into melody by the distance. It still seemed so safe.